Hey, this is Ben here, and I teach you how to write Unity shaders from scratch. In today's video, we're going to do this full screen ripple post effect. Let's jump right into it. All right, so the setup we have in Unity is actually quite simple. All we have is a main camera with a post effects controller on it. Right now, the post effects controller, all it's doing is creating a start render texture, going from the source to start render texture to destination, and then I'm releasing the start render texture. I'm putting everything in post effects material, pass number 3. Therefore, anything that runs on the post effect will be going through this shader, right? This pass. Just a quick test to make sure that this is all working. I'm just going to output the UVs here, i.uv. I'm going to put 0 there and 1 here. Go to the screen, great. And we can see that this i.uv is our screen space UV. We don't have to do any of the screen space math. This is already a post effect. That's why it's working as expected. Cool. So next, what we want to do is we want to create a ring. Like a ripple effect really is a ring that kind of just goes across the screen from the center out to the edges, right? And you probably already have a rough idea of how to do this. What we need to do is do the length from the center, right? So as always, how I usually like to do things is I like to have a new UV, and what I want to do is offset it so that it is, instead of going from 0 to 1, it's going from negative 1 to 1. So we'll do i.uv, and we're going to do times 2 minus 1, right? Cool. So we can see that the zero center is in the middle here, the 0 is in the middle. So doing a ring from the middle, all it is, it's actually just kind of a length. So from the center. So let's first do length. Because the middle is the center, doing the length of i.uv, or sorry, the new UV, should create a gradient from the center. There we go. Now we have a distance or a length. The next thing what we want to do is we want to create a ring. So we want to create a softness in between this length. And in order to do that, as if you guys know softness, we usually use smooth step to do that. And what I like to do is I like to have a feather, an upper feather and a bottom feather. We'll do upper feather and we'll do a bottom feather. And instead of a set color, it should be set float. Yeah, that works. Okay, so let's go back to our post effects controller here, and let's make sure we have access to these two values. So it'll be here. Okay, so let's save it off. Hopefully there's no errors. And let's get this to work. All right, so the first thing we want to do is use a step. We'll do upper ring. This is kind of the upper edge of the ring, right? So a smooth step. So the upper would be a midpoint. We don't have the midpoint, but our midpoint will be a timer because we want this ripple to kind of go from the center outwards, right? So let's do a simple timer. Timer is equal to, let's go time.y, and we're gonna wrap this in a fract. This keeps it between 0 and 1. So a smooth step, we'll do it based off of time. So timer is now our third value. What we need is our length, which I happen to delete. We need our length back. So we'll just do len is equal to length of our i.uv. And what we need to do is an upper and lower range of this length. So we'll do this plus upper range, and we'll do len plus lower range. In fact, I think I'll do minus. Yeah. And then now our ring, let's display it. Cool, so this has worked. However, I forgot to use the new UV. I just went straight into i.uv. By not doing times 2 minus 1, we are doing all of the math from this corner. Like I stated earlier in the video, we need to do everything from the center, right? So now if I modify len from the post effects controller, I should be able to get a bit of range. So let's just say the bottom and upper is 0.1. Now we have this range going on, right? So now we have an upper ring. what we need is a invert of this ring. So the inverse ring is something like this. Float in 1 minus upper ring. Now, if I show the inverse ring, it should be the same thing, but flipped. All right, so finally, now that we have the inverse ring and the upper ring, we need a final ring. Our final value will just be the inverse times the upper ring. And that should get us a ring that is kind of going from the center outwards, right? The whole purpose of this is to get that ring. So, let's call it final. That should get us a ring. All right, so from here, what we need to do is reconstruct our final UV. So let's do float final UV. Float will be float two UVs because UVs are float two. Final UV, and what we need to do is take the new UV and we want to multiply it by our final ring, which is kind of like a mask, right? Let's output that, see what that looks like. Cool, and so we see our ring happening. Finally, what we want to do is add our i.uv onto our final UV, because this ultimately is to sample the full screen. So we need a full screen UV with this ring being manipulated. Cool. So that looks pretty accurate. Let's go ahead and use that to sample our color. So we'll move our color down here. Cull is this final UV instead of i.uv. And then we're going to just display the image. And there you go, that's kind of the start to this ripple effect. Now, notice that the ripple effect is actually inverse. It's actually going smaller before growing bigger. So what we can do is just kind of times minus, multiply this by minus one, or we can just kind of invert this, or we can just subtract that. Yeah, so now we've inverted it. Other things we can do is we can also have a multiplier here. This will help instead of just the final ring. What we can have is an intensity in our post effects controller. Let's add that here. Intensity. If it's your first time here, I just wanted to let you guys know, again, this is not the most ideal way to set up post effects. Usually you have some sort of rendering system that kind of manages all of this. All right, with ripple intensity, we just multiply it onto our final ring. Yeah, it's defaulted to zero. Let's do maybe like 0.2. Yeah, there we go. Another thing that will help make this effect a little nicer sometimes, multiplying it by the timer or the inverse of the timer will help reduce the intensity, especially when it gets to edges, right? So you can times it by 1 minus timer. So when it gets to the edges, it kind of like fades off, right? So it doesn't have that snapping feeling, right? Hey, just wanted to shoot this last little bit here. We can convert this ripple effect where it has an upper ring and a lower ring, where it only produced one ring, to using a sine wave where it's multiple rings. Now the sine is based off of the length. I multiplied by 50 and that controls the number of rings that are here. And a timer is controlling the speed of which it is moving. I did this one last multiplying the 1 minus length so that it fades out nicely. Yeah, so right now we're showing the final ring. If we instead showed color, it would show the final effect that we had before. Yeah, just wanted to share this little bit with you because really this type of effect can be converted into many different things. So yeah, I think that is it for this particular video. I mean, there are many ways you can manipulate this ripple effect. You can make a square, you can make a sphere, you can use an image to kind of drive your ripple to create really cool screen distortions. Yeah, comment below if you guys have some ideas that you want me to share. But yeah, that is it for this particular video. If you guys like what you see, please like and subscribe and support my channel. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye now.